it's especially a good idea here in Corner Brook for you and
yeah,
me,
you
the Prohibition.
Go to those places. Yeah. Now, listen, a lot of people have asked me, why have the Bruins won, what, 15 in a row, or got point 15 in a row, and why the Montreal Canadiens are having a tough time? And I'm going to tell you why. I'm going to show you one little instance. You have to stand up and be counted. You can't look away. Watch Backus right here in Houdon. Watch this here. This is a difference. Cassidy would see this. If this ever was a Boston Bruin, look out. Now watch. He's following him in there, knocks him down, says get up, and now watch the guy look at the referee for a penalty. Backus gets a penalty on. He won't look at him, and he turns around and looks at the referee. No way. You can't do this in hockey. Professional hockey, you cannot. Boston Bruin would never turn away like that. That's why they've got a point in 15 games. That's the way Cassidy wants them to play.
Do you want to have a comment on Freddie Anderson calling out the team a little bit the other day?
All right. It's all right for people to sit here like me, and it's all right for you people to sit home. You don't get 45 shots, 50 shots, 35 shots. He's had more shots on him than anybody in the National Hockey League. He said what had to be said. If nobody else is saying it, he said it. And I don't blame him for sitting up. I've been waiting for somebody to say something like that. Call him out. Get the guys out there. If he's got to do it, he do it. I don't blame Anderson at all.
So the great Stephenville Jets Corner Brook Royals game behind us is deadlocked at a goal apiece here in the third period. And just love the name of the guy who scored the first goal.
Drake.
Dawson Drake. Isn't that something? And Brad Lucas, who got the assist, by the way, on this beautiful goal.
Watch this here.
He's an RCMP officer, the captain, Brad Lucas.
And you know, Ron, these guys are all local guys. These are not imports. They're all guys from right here in Corner Brook. That's why they get to get about 2 or 3 thousand. Looks like they scored again.
Yeah, so it's
scored again.
So that's the
Crowd.
Josh Taylor goal that made it 1-1, and we'll get you the Royals' go-ahead goal here in just a second.
And you know, I watched these guys in the warm-up. I watched those guys. I got chills when I went out. You and I got all carried away. Great guys. They are Canada, as far as I'm concerned.
Tyler Hunt's got the goal that's made it 2-1 here. Another beauty.
All right, come on, let's go.
Well, we're going to show some of the ceremony. You mentioned the Civic Center. It's a packed house here this evening in Corner Brook. And when you went out, we noticed all the players were so excited to see you.
Here I am. I'm walking out. But let me tell you something. Look at all the Mounties in the back and the whole deal. And the players on the other side, the players are on the other side. You could look at them. I got chills. There we're getting there. I'm telling you, boy, this is hockey, being in this country right here, Corner Brook. I'm glad you looked up on that one.
But that could be the worst puck drop in the history of puck drops. Christian Cobley is the assistant coach, and he is sporting your suit here tonight. Does he ever look good? So we got a few little tributes to you. There's Christian. Did a great job. Mr. Leslie's grade fives here in the arena tonight. Pasadena's grade five students drew up some Don Cherries, and they're plastered on the wall here. Don Cherry plastered. I've been looking forward to seeing that.
But plastered many times. Yeah, they got my suits on there. They look good. Isn't that nice? Pasadena Elementary. And, they're pretty good. I must have cut my head off in a lot of places. Anyhow, I love that. I love the people here, as I say, with lovely suits, anyhow.
And you know, Don, you were doing some autograph sessions earlier this afternoon, and we had Al Secord. So I don't know if you saw this. I wanted to spring it on you because I had a great interview. He's a pilot. Imagine he has a great career in the NHL. Then he becomes a captain with American Airlines.
Yeah, I didn't think he was that smart.
So we were connecting, of course, come from away and all that and gander. But I asked him about you, and this is what Al Secord had to say.
He was the best coach that I ever played for. I mean, Don was the kind of guy, he was a player's coach. You wanted to go through the wall for him. He took care of his people, and he was a pleasure to play for. I always appreciated Don's support and words on the telecast through the years. There was a few years where I struggled, and Don came on Hockey Night in Canada, and I did see him by the Toronto Maple Leaf dressing room one day. He said, I'll just keep pressing forward. So he's always been in my corner, and I truly appreciate it.
Yeah, that's good. All right. I didn't know that. Love Al. Boy, he was a left-hander. Could he throw him sometime? I'll tell you the story about him and Hutchinson. Now, we have the prospect game coming up Thursday. We don't have much time. I want to show you tonight. Tell me if I'm wrong. Tonight, playing tonight, these are the guys. Then how many games we got going tonight?
Well, we got six teams playing tonight, but we're including the Flames and the Jets from this afternoon.
These are the guys that have played in the prospect game, believe it or not. All these guys that are playing tonight, and I could go on and on and on. McKinnon and the whole deal. I mean, it was fantastic. There's a guy right there, our, my buddy Tkachuk at the end is straightening them out.
I'm very excited. Eric Lindros is going to be the opposition coach. So they had the great tribute to Eric, obviously, in Philadelphia this week. And that's great of you, Eric, to help out. Here's a couple of guys who you've had who scored nice goals this week. You wanted to start with Vince Dunn, and then Taylor Hall also had a beauty this week.
All right. These are the guys that played for me in the prospect game. We just show you. Give a little elbow there. Watch this here. Dunn puts it in. What a nice kid puts it in. God said he was playing the prospect game. Just thought I'd put that in. And here he is again. Watch Taylor Hall. Imagine what he'd be like, Taylor Hall, right now with McDavid, his best friend. I mean, here, I think he's got 5 goals in 6 games. Isn't that terrific?
So, Grapes, I don't have to tell you that Canada Day in Newfoundland is also Remembrance Day, going back to 1916.
I'm wearing this hat here. I don't know if you can get a close-up of it. It's a Newfoundland, the regiment there, 2nd Battalion, Royal, we get it in here, like that. I'm wearing their tie. That's what I said, boy. These guys, they've been going since 1785. The oldest right there, 1785. And as we're talking this, I'll tell you what happened in the First World War. The cream of the crop in Newfoundland went over there, 800 strong. All volunteers, by the way. 700 of them got killed. It wiped out the cream of the crop of Newfoundland. And I've taken a drink, and I don't drink liquor, boy. I'm telling you, no, boy, that, yeah, yeah. How is that? Sergeant Smith did me that. And I'm going to be the honorary chairman, and they raise money for the statues, and aren't they great guys? I can't say enough about these guys here. The 2nd Battalion, boy, what an honor. Honor, one of the honors, and they pinned the forget-me-nots on there. They pinned those on before the Remembrance Day. Anyhow, this is a highlight for me.
Wow.
Isn't that beautiful? And at the end, I'm just going to show you the guys. About all the guys got the thumbs up. That is Canada, as far as I'm concerned.
Beaumont Hamill, Don Cherry from Cornerbrook on the Coach's Corner on Scotiabank.